Hello everyone, I am Savitri Nagra. Last session we have studied definition of electric traction, types of electric traction, different requirements of electric traction, speed time curve and all. In this session we will continue the traction contents, nature of traction load, important requirements of traction drives, motors used in traction, types of braking, comparison of brakings and types of electrical braking. Nature of traction load. When the train runs at a constant velocity on level track, a number of frictional forces oppose its motion. There are three different frictional forces are internal friction, external friction and air friction. In this internal friction, the friction at bearings, guides etc. are called internal friction. External friction, the friction between wheels and rails is called external friction. Air friction, traction between air and motion of the train is called air friction. Here the motion of train opposes the direction of the wind. All these frictional forces together are called train resistance. The variation of train resistance with the speed time curve. Next we'll move on to important requirements of traction drives. There are two requirements, electric requirements and mechanical requirement. In that we'll first study electrical requirement. It should have high starting torque. It should be simple and easy to control. The speed of the motor should fall with the increase in load. It should have series speed torque characteristics. It should have smooth braking system. It should carry overloads in emergency. It should be capable of withstanding voltage fluctuations without any interruptions. And the motor should be in the position to withstand in a temperature interruption in the supplies. Mechanical requirements. It should carry overloads. The motor should have minimum possible weight. It should be robust and ability to withstand continuous vibrations. It should have high efficiency. It should have minimum weight and it should be compact. Next we'll move on to motors used in traction system. There are three motors: DC series motor, three phase squirrel cage induction motor, permanent magnet synchronous motor. DC series motor. DC series motor develops a high starting torque, which is an essential requirement for traction service. The simplicity and robustness of the DC series motor suitable for all types of traction service used for suburban works. And next one is three phase squirrel cage induction motor. The induction motor is simplest in construction and robust in nature. It is used for speed control of the locomotive. And last one is permanent magnet synchronous motor. The permanent magnet synchronous motors are the traction motors used for electric and road vehicles because of its robustness, nature and simplest construction and easy speed control. Types of braking. There are four types of braking. We'll know first about braking. The action of making a moving vehicles slow down or stop by using a brake. A good braking system should be reliable and quick in its action. The braking force must be capable of being controlled. First one is electrical braking. The process of braking motors rapidly and smoothly in order to properly carry out work operations in industrial installations by use of electric power. Need for electric braking. It is provided to stop the motor quickly, which can be accomplished by the use of either mechanical brakes or electric brakes. Mechanical braking. In mechanical braking, the motor is stopped by using a brake shoe or brake drum. Electrodynamic braking.
in which the stored energy is converted into electrical energy and dissipated in resistance as a heat. Electroregenerative braking. In this braking, the stored energy is converted into electrical energy and it is returned to the supply. So in this braking, the energy will not be wasted. Comparison of electrical braking and mechanical braking. Electrical braking is smoother than mechanical braking. Electrical braking is free from smoke compared to mechanical braking. Electrical braking cannot be applied for all types of motors, whereas mechanical braking can applied for all types of motors. The electrical braking is smoke free. Initial cost of electrical braking is more than that of mechanical braking. The electrical braking is complicated than that of mechanical braking. Electrical braking can stop the motors, but it cannot bring it to stationary. To hold it stationary, mechanical braking is required. In mechanical braking, heat produced at a brake block compared to electrical braking, and the electrical braking reduces wear and tear losses compared to mechanical braking. Next, we'll move on to types of electrical braking. The following are the various types of electrical braking. First one is plugging, second one is rheostatic braking, and third one is regenerative braking. First, we'll know about what is meant by plugging. This is the simple method of electric braking, and it is consist in reversing the connections of armature of the motor so as to reverse its direction of rotation, which will oppose the original direction of rotation of motor. Next one is rheostatic braking. In this method, the braking motor is disconnected from the supply and operated as a generator driven by the kinetic energy of the rotating parts of the motor and its driven machines. Next one is regenerative braking. In this type of braking, the motor is not disconnected from the supply but remains connected to it, and it fetches back the kinetic energy to the supply system. This method is better than the plugging and rheostatic methods of braking, since no energy is wasted and rather it is supplied back to the system. Dynamic or rheostatic braking of DC series motor. This is the diagram of motor in running condition and the motor in braking condition. When the DC series motor is running condition, the armature and the field both are is connected in series, and this is connected across the supply. In running condition, the field current and the armature current both flows in the same direction as shown in the diagram 1. When DC series motor is in braking condition, the armature is disconnected from the supply and connected across a resistance, and the connection of the armature with respect to field are reversed. Therefore, it produces braking torque and it acts as a generator. Here, the kinetic energy is converted into electrical energy and dissipated in resistance as a heat. This is how the diagram is shown in the figure. Regenerative braking with DC series motor. This is the diagram of regenerative braking, which consists of main series field and auxiliary field winding, armature, and this is motoring, and this is braking. In braking, armature, main series field, auxiliary field, winding. To achieve the regenerative braking in DC series motor for the traction, it is essential that the terminal voltage of the DC motor must exceed the supply voltage. The terminal voltage should be exceed the supply voltage. The regenerative voltage should remain constant at all the speed during the period of braking. In trolley buses or a tramways, DC series motor is used, which has one main series field winding and two or three auxiliary field windings as shown in the figure. When the motor is in running condition, the auxiliary field windings are placed in parallel with respect to main series winding. When the motor is in a regenerative braking condition, the auxiliary field windings are placed in series with each other and the combination is connected in parallel across the armature and main series field winding as shown in the diagram. Next we'll move on to current collection through single arm pantograph, which consists of overhead lines, current collector fan, steel alloy pantograph, spring, train and track. The pantograph collector is current collection fan. It is in diamond shape fan. It mounted on the top roof of the vehicle. It is used where the vehicles run at high speeds of 110 km to 130 km and where currents to be collected are 2000 ampere to 3000 ampere. It consists of pentagonal framework of high tensile alloy steel tubing. The contact portion consists of steel with copper strips, which are forced against the overhead contact wire by the upward direction of pantograph springs. Next, we'll go to train lighting system, which consists of Rosenberg generator, rectifier, battery, control circuit, train lighting system, and train system. The electric supply provides to the lights of fans in the trains is from Rosenberg generator. When train is in motion, the generator is coupled to the driving wheels of the locomotive, and here the mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy, that is AC form, and is fed to the lighting system of the train and also charge the batteries by rectifying AC to DC. When the train is at rest, the generator gets disconnected and the battery circuit get automatically switched on by using control circuits, that is inverter. It convert DC to AC and fed to train lighting system. This is how train lighting system works.